stunt 101. I shoot you out of stunt, my wrist stay rocked till my TVs pop up in the Maybach Benz. I shoot you out of stunt, nigga, you can't see me, my Bentley GT got smoke gray tint. I shoot you out of stunt, my neck stay blingin', my rims stay gleamin', I'm shining, man. I shoot you out of stunt, I see you scheming, nigga, keep on dreaming, I hurt you, man. I shoot you out of stunt, 7 series BM, 6 series Benz, 24 inches.
Okay, so I'm gonna be doing an update, or a full setup video right now, as requested by pretty much everyone. And yeah, this angle might be familiar because it's the same angle I did in the 2009 setup video. And yeah, okay, so starting over here, you got the chair, same pretty much. There's a phone over there now. You got the speaker on the speaker stand, couch, added a chessboard to it, looks pretty cool, pretty sweet. Xbox controller, a universal remote, Blu-ray remote, Bose remote, and in here's just a bunch of magazines, Google AdSense thing there, Pleo card, in here is really well, batteries, controller cases, more remotes, got a lot of stuff, a lot of remotes, and yeah. So here under there's the Microsoft Desktop Entertainment 7000. Moving up here, you got the projector screen remote, which when you click down, obviously it comes down.
We're in a different time zone, your records don't reach us, nah, I ain't here to save the world.
So over here you got the Bose Lifestyle 48 control center, speaker on the speaker stand, some shells, two game magazines, the Bravia 40 inch, the XBR, the Bose middle speaker. By the way, all this is full HD as well. We got the Blu-ray player there, Western Digital TV Live there, Foxtel IQ 2. I changed that to Pioneer so I can switch up to good audio inputs, but yeah. The white PS3, the Nintendo Wii, Xbox 360 Elite, another PS3 up here, two Xbox 360 wireless mics, a white PS3 controller, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 controller, two Chasers Warrant Everything DVDs back there, the Xbox 360 Guitar Hero guitar, Stickman figure, and what's completely new about this is everything here is now under cable management, so there's a ton of cable management installed now. I spent the past couple of days just installing it alone. This stuff isn't the best cable management here, but this stuff is really good. This stuff over here is really good. It's like PVC and just hides all of it. So over here, I added a games cabinet. Let's see if I open that. It has all my games in it and Blu-rays. So you can just go through. I'm not gonna read them out. So yeah, 2012 on Blu-rays at the top. The bamboo over here, the Sony photo frame here, which of course is just above this. It has cable management as well, pretty cool. I don't know if you can see that bar right there, but that's all cables that have now been managed. It was just crazy with Ethernet cables, power cables, etc. So down here you got the Xserve. Basically, it's Apple's server, pretty obviously, but it serves all my media files, basically. So if I want to listen to some music on my main computer, I'll use this server to stream it there. And video files and all that type of stuff, I use it for that. It's a really nice product. and it has some of my really important files on it. Really nice. You've got a front USB port there. And also, just for you people that want to know, what the server does is, a server can be used for multiple things. Mine's used as a home server, you can use it for web serving, and you know, you can even use it if you want to send, your exporting, like if you want the server to handle your exporting from Final Cut. I believe they released the Final Cut server, so you can use that to encode if you have a powerful server. Then, let's say you're doing it on a Mac Mini, you can throw it over here and it'll do it for you, then send it back. So that's pretty cool. It can be used multiple things. So I can't really explain in that, but that's a few examples. It'll also be used to run security systems, etc. It's really just an always-on computer. So you got the DVD drive here, the induction ports here. Pretty cool Apple logo there. So it's sitting on a cabinet, which is pretty fairly high off the ground. And then over here is the Canon Pixma MP830. Quite a nice printer, actually. Of course, at the back, you got the cables coming out of the server. Now, I couldn't do much for right here, but I don't know if you can see that, but at the back, I've sort of installed tubing around there. And you can just sort of see. It took me about 3 days straight just to install all the cable management in here. So just for people that don't know, I don't do the setup videos to show off, it's just to show how I've set it up. The same amount of people can have the same equipment as me, but can have it set up like shit, and you know, that it's not that good. Pretty cool. I believe that's 35, 4, 3, I don't know. Not actually 100% sure on that. But yeah, that is the secondary screen for the server. So some of the people probably haven't seen is the cupboard right here. it's really a water heater cupboard, like an electricity to run the electricity in this room, really. But I've managed to put some cupboards and that in here, so it's sort of storage in that. It just holds some stuff, so it's not really that interesting. You have 2 1-terabyte hard drives there. The universal touchscreen remote, the Harmony 1000, I believe. Universal remote there. Just a box full of stuff there. Dick Smith drill. Pretty cool. And for people that ask, I still do have the G25. It's in here. I use it occasionally. So down here you got a bunch of inks, cable ties, the Mac Pro box thing, the X stand there, an old HP computer, a Stanley screwdriver set, a G25 gear stick. And obviously these are just shells. Pretty much some cleaning supplies in there. An MX Revolution, Snow Leopard, and my old router. Cable clips and a Stanley leveler. 2 old hard drives. My old projector. Up here's the Companion 5 welcome CD, I guess. This is one of the really old Apple connectors that you can connect to, like composite. Pretty cool. Yeah, this video. iLife 08 and iLife 09. This is the adapter plugs for your, well, I think MacBook Pro and iPods and that. This is the mini display port to dual link DVI adapter, which I'm using currently. This is the VESA mount adapter for any of your Apple screens or iMacs. Pretty cool. This is the Netgear router, the AirPort Extreme router, the Time Capsule box. Up here is Final Cut Express Force, Final Cut Express HD, ThinkGeek Snowbot. There's like a charging cable here, and like a cable drop there to hold it. You can plug your iPhone into there. Up here, there's the Mac Mini, Mac Mini currently isn't used really for that much, but yeah, it's pretty cool. It's not actually on right now. Two copies of Windows Vista Home Premium, some power saver switch that glows, pretty cool. Pep Wiles keyboard, iPhone 3G, iPhone and iPhone 3GS box. So you can see that's the original iPhone box, that's the 3G and that's the 3GS. iClear, you can clean your Apple stuff with it. iPhone dock, Bose bag. Up here is an iMac G5, I believe. Yeah. And that's a Sony S-Frame, Logitech M950 performance mouse box. And this is Tony Hawk's actual signature that I got when I was in Fiji. Pretty cool. Yeah, pretty sweet. So yeah. Oh, and this is one of the screens I'm not using currently. So yeah, that concludes the cupboard tour, I guess. Now over here, over the bar area, that's a Jim Beam Racing shirt signed by a bunch of people. Some cameras are along here. These glasses, these are really fucking sick. They actually release gas from the bottom, like if the water I think is uneven, or I'm not actually sure how this works, but it releases gas from the bottom, which is pretty sweet. That's some bamboo there. Very nice. I'm gonna get a frame for this soon. But this is all used, this is all made using spray cans, pretty sweet. So this is the ThinkGeek, like tells you if the water's cold, and if the water's hot. Like, if I got a hot water now. It'll turn to red, pretty cool. So that's a pencil holder there. Bose sound dock over there, my iPhone there. Under here's not that tidy, but still. Bose over your headphones box, just a bunch of other crap. Desktop 8000 under there. Apple keyboard, Comic Live, Norton Antivice for Mac, HP printer, pretty cool. Samsung bar fridge that I haven't really restocked yet. Pretty much drank everything inside of it. And that's the other speaker there on the speaker stand. That's a Scarface picture that was painted. Pretty sweet. Very nice, I like that. That's the projector, the Epson TW2000. Very cool. Obviously there's component and HDMI running off of it. That's original film stills from The Godfather, part 1, 2 and 3. Pretty sweet. So now getting onto the main part. This is where I do all my work. You can see that's the Companion 5 series speakers there. The M950 performance mouse, Denovo Edge. That's a Dell 30-inch screen, that's the Apple 30-inch screen. Both are very nice, but the Dell I don't use that much. That's the Samsung P1950 monitor with the LifeCam Cinema on top of it. Pretty cool. That's the other Companion 5 speaker. It's a Snowball mic, the Bowser Milk and Zeppelin, which is a iPhone and iPod sound dock if you don't know what that is. The Mac Pro 2009 model. Bose over-ear headphones. Very nice. My chair, which is pretty fucking sweet. I just upgraded that. Very comfortable. Now, I don't always vouch for Bose, but I'm not sure exactly what model this is, because I know that the older model of these sound better than the newer ones. This may be the old, I'm not 100% sure, but they're really, really good. I'm actually getting the Ultrasone Pro 900 soon, but these are very, very nice. I'm not getting the Ultrasone Pro 900 really just to be wasteful, but if you want to look up EMF, it can cause brain cancer and whatnot. With headphones, I've used headphones a lot, you can actually get brain cancer from it. So you might want to look into that, just to let everybody know. Lifecam Cinema, pretty nice. That also has cable management on it. So like I said, there's a lot of cable management. That's the iMac, 24-inch. This is the wireless Apple keyboard with the iClear on top of it. The Magic Mouse with the palm rest, which you need because it's so low profile. But yeah, pencil holder, pretty nice. The stand, the Mac Air City stand for the iMac. This is the X stand for the iPhone. Matches the stand of the iMac. Pretty cool. Back here is my 1 terabyte Maxter drive. 320 gig, I believe, drive for this. Samsung netbook mouse. And just a whole bunch of stuff down there. And that's the area behind the iMac and the Mac Pro. And you can see that's also got cable management as well. That's the remote, which is now on the wall. Not really that anybody cares, but yeah. That's the air conditioner up there. Very nice air conditioner. All the cables used to go across there are now managed by that. Can't see anything. Underneath my desk, that's a Mac Pro as well. You only see one wire, which is that, which is a necessity to go up. But all the rest is held up. It's pretty cool. That is the Mac Pro. That's my desk. It's extremely big, which is good. But yeah. Behind the TV, there's the time capsule, the base for the Bang & Olufsen phone, where all the wires come out of the projector behind there, and that's like the grill with Ethernet and stuff. All the controls have now been put up here because I got a ton of extra space because of that CD holder there. So yeah, if you enjoyed my setup, subscribe.